Part 51, selection, meaning and process. Selection is the process of picking or choosing the right candidate who is most suitable for a vacant job position in an organization. In other words, selection can also be explained as the process of interviewing the candidates and evaluating their qualities which are required for a specific job and then choosing the suitable candidate for the position. The selection of a right applicant for a vacant position will be an asset to the organization, which will be helping the organization in reaching its objectives. Employee selection is a process of putting a right applicant on a right job. Selection of an employee is a process of choosing the applicants who have the qualifications to fill the vacant job in an organization. Selection is a process of identifying and hiring the applicants for filling the vacancies in an organization. Employee selection is a process of matching organization's requirements with the skills and the qualifications of individuals. A good selection process will ensure that the organization gets the right set of employees with the right attitude. Selection means to select the proper candidate from the applications received. Selection is a part of the recruitment process. The selection process varies from organization to organization on the basis of size, type of organization, and the kind of employees required. There are three levels of management in all large enterprises: top, middle, and bottom level management. At different levels of management, different type of qualified employees are required. The selection procedure for non-managerial staff is short and simple, while the selection procedure for top managerial positions is of a special nature and well planned. It is necessary to select the right person for the right job, as selection of an employee is a very important aspect. The selection of a suitable, expert, experienced, and loyal employee is an invaluable asset for the enterprise. In shortly, selection means to select the proper candidate from the applications received. Selection is a part of recruitment process. In different organization, the process of selection is found to be different. It is based on the basis of size, type of the organization, and kind of employee required. The selection procedure for non-managerial staff is very short and simple compared to the top level managers. The selection procedure for top level managerial positions is of a special nature and well planned. It is necessary to select the right person for the right job, as selection of an employee is very important aspect. The selection of a suitable, expert, experienced, and a loyal employee is an invaluable asset for the enterprise. The process of selection. Selection is a process of identifying and hiring the applicants for filling the vacancies in an organization. Employee selection is a process of matching organization's requirements with the skills and the qualifications of individuals. First one, welcoming and primary meeting. At this stage, the candidate is welcomed by the enterprise. The receptionist makes the primary investigation, and if the candidate is found suitable, eligible, he will be sent to the recruitment officer. The recruitment officer collects information about the knowledge, skill, and the working capacity of the candidate. The main objective at this stage is to prevent the improper, unsuitable candidate, from applying in the initial stage. If the candidate is found suitable in the primary meeting, he will be asked to fill in the application form. This saves the time of the recruitment officer, and the process also becomes symbol. In this welcoming and primary meeting, the organization will call the interested candidate to the organization. First stage, the reception stage, make a primary investigation and check some details and send it to the recruitment officer. That recruitment officer collects information about the knowledge, skill and capacity of the candidate and check that the person is suitable for this work. Then the main objective of this type of selection process is to avoid unsuitable candidate from applying in the initial stage. If the candidate is found suitable in the primary meeting, he will be asked to fill in the application form and informed to proceed the further details. This type of selection process will save the time of the recruitment officer and the process make very simple. And second process of selection is receiving and screening of applications. The recruitment officer gets information about the educational qualifications, experience, knowledge and skill of the candidate. If the candidate along with the application sends different documents of his qualifications like mark sheets, experience certificates, etc. filled in the applications which are found incomplete or wrong are rejected after screening. The selection process often begins with an initial screening of applications to remove individuals who obviously do not meet the position requirements. At this stage, a few straightforward questions are asked. An applicant may obviously be unqualified to fill the advertised position but be well qualified to work in the other open positions. The purpose of screening is to decrease the number of applicants being considered for selection. And the third stage, taking necessary tests. Various type of tests are conducted for those candidates whose applications are accepted. Every enterprise conducts tests in its own way. Various tests are conducted to know their mental ability, skill, aptitude, and efficiency, etc. Personal testing is a valuable way to measure individual characteristics. Hundreds of tests have been developed to measure various dimensions of behavior. The tests measure mental abilities, knowledge, physical abilities, personality, interest, temperament, and other attitudes and behaviors. Evidence suggests that the use of tests is becoming more relevant for assessing an applicant's qualifications and potential for success. Tests are used more in the public sector than in the private sector and in medium-sized and large companies than in small companies. Large organizations are likely to have trained specialists to run their testing programs. And the first test, IQ test. IQ test is meant to assess the common sense, memory, smartness, power of decision making and thinking capacity, etc. So IQ test, candidates intelligence, memory power, smartness, thinking power, decision power, etc. can be known. And second test, aptitude test. This test is meant to know whether the candidate has interest for the specific work or not for which he is selected. Through aptitude test, it is tried to know that is the work for which candidate is selected, whether he is interested in the same work or not. Third one, trade test. This test is meant to decide whether the candidate has the necessary skill to perform the expected job or not. Through trade test, it is known that the work for which candidate is selected, how much ability he has for the said work. And fourth one, psychological test. This test is meant to know about the nature, self-confidence, attitude, and habits of the candidate. Through psychological test, candidate's nature, approach, habit, honesty, self-confidence, etc. can be known. Fourth one, personal interview. Candidates who succeeded in the above test are called for personal interview. A committee is formed for the selection of candidates. In this way, assessment can be made without any bias. The interview committee consists of representatives of the management, the departmental head, the personnel managers, and experts from various fields. Work-related questions are asked. Proper care is taken so that there is no deviation from the topic. At this stage, the terms and conditions of the job can be made clear. An interview is a goal-oriented conversation. Conversation in which the interviewer and the applicant exchange information. Employment interview is especially significant because the applicants who reach this stage are considered to be the most promising candidates. Interview planning is essential to effective employment interviews. The physical location of the interview should be both pleasant and private, providing for a minimum of interruptions. The interviewer should possess a pleasant personality, empathy, and the ability to listen and communicate effectively. He or she should become familiar with the applicant's qualifications by reviewing the data collected from other selection tools in preparing for the interview. A job profile should be developed based on the job description. Fifth point, checking references. The information given by the candidate in the application form should be checked by referring to his present and past employers to get an idea of the correct situation. To get the right opinion about an employee, the information collected should be free from any bias. The opinion of the reference given by the candidates helps in taking right decision. Checking reference means the person who gives the reference of a potential employee is also a very important source of information. The referee can provide information about the person's capabilities, experience in the previous companies, and leadership and managerial skills. The information provided by the referee is meant to kept confidential with the HR department of the organization. And the sixth process, preliminary selection. If the matters gathered from personal interview and the past references are positive, then the selection committee will make a list of selected candidates. This list is usually includes more number of candidates than required. If candidate is found suitable in personal interview and other process of the organization, after selection committee make a list of candidates. In this list, number of candidates are kept more than the number required for the organization. Seventh process of selection, physical or medical examination. After a preliminary selection of the required candidates, they are sent to a specified hospital or doctor for medical examination. The main objective of this examination is to know whether the candidate is suffering from any serious illness or any other physical problem. Rest of the employees are kept in waiting list. In future, whenever any candidate is required, selection can be done from this waiting list according to their order of merit. The medical exam is also a very important step in the selection process. Medical exams help the employers know if any of the potential candidates or selected candidates are physically and mentally fit to perform their duties in their job. A good system of medical checkups ensures that the employees standards of health are higher and there are fewer cases of absenteeism, accidents and employee turnover. So every organization, most of the big organization have medical as well as the physical examination before the final appointment. Most of the organization before final appointment day, they are going to do this physical and medical examination. Eighth process, appointment letter. After making the final selection, appointment letter is given to the selected candidate. In this letter, information regarding nature of work, workplace, designation, rights and responsibilities, remuneration and other financial and non-financial details are given. This is the final step in the selection process. Appointment process, appointment letter is the final step in the selection process. After the fully passed all written tests, interviews and medical examination, the employee is sent or emailed appointment letter confirming his selection to the job. The appointment letter contains all the details of the job like work hours, salary, leave allowance, information about the work, workplace, designation, right and responsibilities, and other benefit to the employees also. Often, employees are hired on a conditional basis where they are hired permanently after the employees are satisfied with their performance. And the last process of selection, induction into the organization and the allotment of work. In modern organization, after giving the appointment letter and before the allotment of duties, employees are given information regarding the policies of the organization, organization environment, superiors, colleagues and subordinate. After these duties are allotted to the candidate. In modern organization, after giving the appointment letter and just before the allotment of work, the employee want to familiar with the working condition, organization's aspect nature, organization policies and organizational surroundings, superiors, colleagues and subordinate. And after this process, the work is allotted to various candidates. These are the processes included in selection. First one, welcoming and primary meeting. Second one, receiving and screening of application. Taking service test, IQ test, aptitude test, trade test and psychological test. Personal interviews, checking reference, preliminary selection, medical or physical examination, appointment letter and induction into the organization and allotment of work.